For those who don't know me, I've been working with photojournalists for the last 18 years. I started when I was 17, and before that I was actually into theater. And then I had a little bit of a crisis when I was 17 and discovered I didn't want to do that anymore, and went to Prague to cover the G8 meetings. And the background is a little bit, I mean, interesting what comes in the future. In the beginning, it was just an adventure. I didn't know anything about photojournalism. I didn't know how to tell a story. And what comes afterwards, with all the traveling discovering journalism, that's when I grow my paddles, or so to say. But that's before. The project that I'm working now on, I found 8 years ago. And I was covering a story for Newsweek about suicide bombers in Kabul with Ron Moreau. And after all big conflicts, basically what we're doing is trying to find these corny stories. For example, you had this Baghdad heavy metal band that was pretty big, it went into a documentary. And people intend to do that kind of stories afterwards. And I found the cinema, and I thought it was really interesting in the beginning to just go there and see what's going on and try to find a quirky story about the post-war society. And when I started there, I didn't have any more intention to just spend 1 week there. But I completely fell in love with the place immediately. And after that week, I went back. I lived in India for 3 years and went back to India, started to edit my pictures. And I realized that something was missing in the pictures. And that was my first meeting with the difference between documentary and pictures. Because there was I don't know the English word for that, skeende, emotion in the house, in the building, with the people, that was impossible to capture in still pictures. So when I started to work with the pictures, I quickly realized that this is not a picture story. I didn't know what was actually missing. But then slowly, after a couple of months, I realized that this is a fantastic documentary. But I didn't know how to film. And at that time, 8 years ago, the digital cameras wasn't good enough to start working with. So you had to do it with 16 millimeters or 35 millimeters. And to just go and shoot with 35 millimeters for try, it's super expensive and really hard. You don't know what you're doing and how to expose the right. So I just thought that, well, I have to learn film first and then do the documentary. So basically the last 8 years has been an aim to learn how to film in the way to actually start making this film, Cinema Pamir. And the first idea about the documentary film Cinema Pamir was basically to just capture this beautiful place. And it slowly developed into a story where we are now, basically. As I told you, I mean, the last 8 years, 18 years, I've been covering conflicts, more into a hardcore news photography. Been sent to different conflict areas, Iraq, Afghanistan, Indonesia, larger parts of Africa, covering all the riots up in the Arab Spring. And it's really been hard to reach out with that kind of stories. Either it's too bloody, and I think that with mainly, I mean, most of the pictured stories or also written stories when it comes to conflict, people are curious about, I mean, the immediate situation of the place. But to really reach out with this kind of stories is super hard. As I told you, I mean, it's either too bloody and nobody wants to see the pictures, or it's too narrow and you only touch people who already knows everything about the situation, and you get a applause from just the already crowd that knows everything about it. Or it's too beautiful, which is a super difficult part also. Taking pictures and suddenly your pictures become a piece of art. And 2 weeks later, nobody reflects what the picture is actually about. I did a lecture in Konsthögskolan in Stockholm and compared, I took out a couple of examples from John Grarup and a couple of other photographers, and showed them on the screen and just like asked the audience, do you actually know legendary photos where, I mean, what's the picture is about? And nobody could answer. And that's a very big issue. So the film is, as you mentioned, a looking glass over society in Afghanistan. But the whole idea is also to not mention too much details of Afghanistan. And this is, we are not finished yet with the film, far from. We did the main filming in 2015, the autumn. And the way that we captured the film, or scenes, is that we just basically put on mics on each character. So we had four main characters that we were following. And we started each morning to just map them down and see what we got the day before. And then we were just following them. And that is everybody that I spoke with earlier, well-known directors, really giving me advice to try to avoid that kind of capture of material, because it is the hardest thing to do when it comes to documentary, to actually don't have an idea what you're actually telling the story about. but that's what I think it's, I mean, super interesting when it comes to documentaries, where you don't have your own idea, when you're looking at it like you did it in the 70s, basically. So you're trying to be this fly on the wall and trying to discover what's actually going on the ground. But now in the edit room, it's very complicated to actually form a story that is still interesting to look at and not fiction made. But the whole idea also with this story, because as I told you, it's very hard to reach out with this kind of stories. So the purpose with this film is basically, as we talk about in the tagline that we have, there's a huge difference between living and surviving. And that's what the whole film is about. So you basically don't need to understand that it's in Afghanistan. You don't need the history of Afghanistan. You don't need to know who killed who in this conflict. This film can be applied to any conflicts around the world. I hope. We'll see how it goes. But I'm, as I said, yeah, this is a still work in progress. We have now been editing for 2.5 years, I think. And not in a constant way, but every now and then we get more money, and then the money runs out, so we have a couple of 2 weeks of editing and 4 weeks of editing, and then we take a step back and let it mature, but also apply for new money. So it's this constant struggle of everything to make this film. And now we're in the last process, hopefully, to edit the film. And the clips that I'm going to show you is two scenes. You're meeting two of the characters that are involved in the film. Let's see if this works out. Airbus space.
John Green, take a chance on a good thing. The piece of this is my job. Oh, yeah.
The
پاکستان چه می دهد و خوب شش ماه سال مردم می بینم فرما کنه شو که من ایجنا و مردم می ایجنا و است فهمیدی جب ندیده با این ندیده می باشه مردم نه میگه نا و است و یک خوب فلم در دیران مفتی کنده شو که ایجنا مردم می ایجنا و است جب ندیده می باشه مردم نه
Den ser vi den där tjänsten har stannat skött på dig. Chanto. Låt dem se det bättre nu. Majer mig. Damvakt. Tjö. Bara lejtarna. دیگه ما یک وقت بازی کلارا میمونم کلارا در فرق میمونم کس رشخندی میکرد حالا که گوش نداره هنه ایتر هست هنه ایتر هست سر زیر سایی بچه بالا هست دیگه باز یک انیوالم گفت بگینم دشمال هنه این بغلش نه تتا کن بسته کن هیت بیغم باش دیگه توکل بخورم خودم دلکارم نیستم مقصد از مقصد جورش میکنم که بگم از کجاست پیسیش از رای چی میامدم که از رای ریشخور 18 سال سنده ما بود نمی یاد پول گذرگاه ما را گرفتن
باش نزمی بنا نمی یک در او سلک باشه
مرون تجاک شدیم گفت امیاد که کس تیر میشه که صدا مگریسی بایسی بیا آدم خوشکله دیگه کش کرده میده مطمئن چی گناه کنیم چی را تو میکنی گفت نه خو پرت زیر خلطه چی ها رو دمی کلیم ها کش کن بوجی بدهد پشت سرم از رسپانا واس که دوست انداختش دیگه مرا بالا کردن دو موتر مادیم نه جاسوس هستیم نه دیگه ما یک غریب کار هستیم اینه یک سر یک لک دو لکه که میمونه افغانی ما بوده خرچ فامیل میکنیم و کش کرد بردم یکیش میگه از این میخوای ششنجا دین در سرش یکیش میگه نه برو بانش خیلی جوان از بیچانه از سر طرف دادم گفت خیلی روغن هم پرتی سرش همی یک کلاگک مداشم کلاگک موز کردم کلایش رو سکم زیک سلی زد کلای موز هفتیم کلای موز هفتیم روغن از سر کرده اینمی جمان داخت گفت تبیگه تا یت بی ما یت گرفتم از اینمی که روغن انداخت اینم تو کفتی چکی دای تا اینجا این شانه مون کله زیت وقتم پشت سر است یک این قایق داغن بود ما یت کردم مرجل که باز دادگاه جان چین تاسم ما یت گفت کردم که می این روغن دیام چسب گفت دای نو پارت سر دست ما من روغن نگم ما بعد از سیروس نگم ما با جان خود نمیفهمم دمن یک جای انداخته بود ده 20 نفر بودیم حتی ما اونجا با چشمای گناهکار خود دیدم قسم سر مک نداری که حتی سینه های زنها را تو میگذن به قیچی میبرین گوش ما را خاموجا کردیم و روغن که انداختن ایتا که چسبیده بود بخی وضوع کردیم قیچی بولیدم میگرم حالا میشه قیچی سمت برای ما سه روز در اونجا ما بال مال نبودم بال که آمدم یک داره که وفو و شوائی میکنم بعد این موتر آوردن مرا دیم پل گزرگاه بغل باغوش یعنی اینجا تایم کرد گفت دمی دریا و ما اینجا در دوربین سعی میکنیم که دمی دریا روان باشی که در دیگه جای نری که میزنم به تدامی کدی داشکه Thank you. چیزی که نظر خدا دیگه چیز گفته نمیتونیم بچه قسمت نصیب ما بوده مردم ها در آتیر شدن این تاری مایده تورتا تورش کده بعد ما شکر و جای شکر میکشی که مقام زنده هستیم حالا
Vad ser om den? Ja, vi kör det andra klippet också. Kommer jag till andra klippet? Andra hållet så... Där har vi honom.
Vai vai, vai vai mera mano kariwa zipa. Yak salam zomba, bakhair sir. Yak duaban khuda, sabat bakhair. Khub, albatta, ar insan. یک دوره جوانی را تیر میکنه یک سرگذشت میداشته باشه بله میرم بازیگش پیش نگاه کنم فکر میکنم که می سنای 18 یا 19 بودیم در می سینمای بارستان بودیم خب
بادر جان، جوره سی، تو چه بچه جوره؟
در اون زمان تو بگویم که تو مملکت ما رو به ترقی بود و پیشرفت بود، مردم تند و تاریکی بود مثل کالس نبودن و چون مال گناهش هم 30 سال در جنگ تیر کردن سواد و درس و تعلیم تربیه بسیار کم بودن نارس بود شدن هکو دام مشکلی نبوده. با آمدن فامیلا بالاخره روز از روزها یکی از این فامیلا دخترکش چون همسن سال ما بود بعد از اینکه محبت در دل با ما داشت لیکن به زبان نمیگفت مصطفی جان کمک چون با ما صحبت کرد و بالاخره گفت فردا میایم یا پس فردا میایم امروز پس فردایش که آمد اما که مثلا برمک چوکیت و جای مانده بود بعدی که فلم شروع شد و گفت یک دقیق با صحبت دارم خب کشیستم کتش بفرما چی مشکل چی امر که مجرا کنیم بالاخره از زبانش برآمد که ما مثلا دوست دارم محبت با تو دارم و میخوایم که با تو من ازدواج کنم بازمو بود که مثلا یک لرزش در وجود من پیدا شد چون به خاطر که در این رشته اصلا نبودیم و فکرش هم نمیکردم با گفتن از اونا من اگر کم تو مثلا خود از زز دادم و بالاخره حتی سر مرق آمد خب باز بالا بالاخره چون چوکی ها بود دستم تو ماندگی بود اما دست خود اک سر دستم اما فکر کن که مرد یک برق دیگه گرفت باز یک مدت زمانه یک خط آور دمه داد البته چیزی که گفتارش بود برای من گفته بود در میخواد متاسف همه خط شگرفتم به نوشی ما به بادا صورت های در پیران خود ماندم با رهنمایی رفتم پس در کار خود رفتم اما متاسف همه که میخواد با کار در کار از یخن مفتاده بود از پیران من چون پیران وظیفه بود بر آمده بود اما با گم شدن خط و بسیار ازش خواهش کردم، گفتم خط گم شده، بسیار خواهش کردم که دادان خدا دادان سر پدر و مادرت یک از اموی یکی مشتک و کافی آره که در دل ما کاف مانده. این همه که در دل خود از او کاف مانده، دل ما هم کافتم مانده، از پیشم که خداحافظی گرفت که رفت. واقعا دیزیش میکنم که از دل جان محبت داشت به ما، دوستم داشت و ما هم دوستش داشتم. بسیار دختر خوب بود، مهربان بود، بسیار دلسوز بود. ولیکن اما تو قلب مرم شکستان که خوب کرد که برای من هم در تردیب شد که نباید از در وقتی که سر پای خود استاد نشی کس را وعده نکو، کس را وعده نکو، با کسی دوستی نکو، کس از کس را مثلا آمختیت نساز که از دست چیز آمده نکو.
So that's two clips from the films. So it's a very, I mean, what you've seen, it's very rough. We haven't done the sound, it's still not graded, and the translation is really bad. The last person you met is Said. Can we just... Said is the main character, so he's the manager on the cinema, and he is the person that actually takes you through the whole film. And the first guy that you met is Nakib, and he's just a bouncer, that's side characters. But what I think it's interesting to, what I'm trying to apply to the film is not to talk about who's done who. I mean, you never mentioned who did this terrible thing to him. You never mentioned which civil war it was. Which I find, I mean, it's part of the key elements in the film to not talk about those skin things, which make it into a political film if that was the case. So the aim is to make it into a humanitarian film and talk about the conflicts and the effects that war is shit and the civilian is captured in between it. And basically that's what we're always trying to do. This is just another way to try to tell that kind of story.